Hello, everyone. Welcome to Drafting with Jamie Topples for ChannelFireball.com. Today we're doing an M21 draft on Arena. Best of three, of course. Love sideboarding. Big fan. That's what we're doing. Pack one, pick one. All right. Choices. Harbinger. Love that card. Avengers, quite sweet. Have you ever had a deck with three Avengers? Because I have. Actually, I had four. I think I had four in one deck before. It was pretty awesome. Fright Green is strong in this format. This is an attack format. Avenger's good. Is it worth taking over Harbinger? No, probably not. I think Harbinger's pretty cool. A 4-3 for 3, sign me up. Hexproof from black? Great. Can't get grasped. It's also a rare, so it equals jemmies for me, because I have the whole collection, so I'm a little bit inclined to take the Harbinger here. It's a good card. I love Avenger. Red-green is solid. But seeing a gold card, pack one, pick one is... It's always defensible if it's strong, which this card is strong. But it's better to not commit to two colors right away, right? So, Harbinger it is. I'm hoping to wheel Pride Malkin. Probably won't, because people are hot to that card being amazing. Yeah. I don't think it's coming back. I don't know what... Yeah. It should be interesting to see what comes back from that pack. But I'm taking the strongest card. Okay. I'm going to take the Mauler here, mostly because I'm not excited about any of the other cards in this pack. Charge is a good 2-drop, just kidding. I have a little bit of excitement for that card. A 3-1 of this format's great, and then it gets a bonus. Yes! But I'm going to take Mauler to cut green. I do want to play green, and honestly, yeah, there's no... I don't feel there's any reason for me to move into a different color here. So I'm not gonna. Mauler it is. I think... Celestia is my favorite deck in this format. The counters deck with Conclave Mentor. It's pretty special. I enjoy it. So that's what I'm hoping to go into with this. Mauler goes in counters. I mean, if I'm going to be in the counters deck, I really don't want very many 4-drops unless they're Acolytes. So Mauler doesn't usually even make the cut. Unless you have, like, the cat rare or something, like if there's a real reason to play that. But once again, like, okay, so I like Ghoul, but that goes in life gain, which we are nowhere near. And yeah, there's a steep drop off after that. I mean, Turn to Slag is a fine removal spell. It's a little expensive, but I will always play like 1 to 2 of these in any red deck. It's fine. I'd prefer Dragon Fires, of course, and Shocks, but sometimes you just need to deal 5 damage to a target creature. It gets the job done. It's okay. I don't think it's a reason to move into red here. I'm just going to take a Mauler. Everything else is pretty underwhelming. So yeah, we'll see. Hopefully these packs get more exciting. Ooh. Opt. I actually really like Opt. If we could end up in... I'm going to take this Avenger. Dang it. Okay, so I'm going to take this Avenger and hope we wheel the second Avenger. Now, taking the Shock here, like Shock is a very good removal spell in this deck. But if I'm going to take a red card, that would mean I'm moving into red-green. And if I'm passing an Avenger, that's not good for signaling. I will definitely get cut in red-green in the next pack if I do that. So I'm going to leave the Shock here begrudgingly. Okay, this is a great removal spell. It's super cheap. But I'm going to take the Avenger and hope to get some more removal later. I think this is a good reason to move into red-green, and hopefully the other one will wheel. I mean, I guess not. That pack was pretty bad. So maybe that's something to consider. Maybe I should let everybody else fight over red and take the Gale Swooper. I didn't think about that. I don't think that first Avenger's coming back. I'm going to audible into this Gale Swooper. I feel like red's going to really... dry up next pack, but no worries, because I like Pride Malkin here a lot. Titanic Growth is a solid combat trick as well, but yeah, since that Avenger, like, I pass an Avenger, right? So I think I'm probably going to get cut in red-green. Even though I love red-green, okay, it's fun. The more Avengers you have, the better. That's a great card. They get better in multiples as well, because 4 power or greater. They add mana, and it can... It's great. Because, like, you can just start hitting the like your opponent's face and doing damage that way with the activation when you have a ton of mana. So I enjoy it, but I'm concerned that I will get cut and run. It felt really bad because I saw a Dragonfire next, but I think it was right. Okay, so I could take Mauler number 3 to cut green. There's a Turnus lag, so had I taken the Avenger, I think I would have done okay. I might speculate on Unsubstantiate here because I do have a decent shell for blue-green, but I'm going to take the Mauler. Well, actually, Skyscanner. I don't really need another 4-drop. Okay, I'm going to take Skyscanner. I don't know what my second color is. That's my defense here. I think Unsubstantiate is defensible. I miss the red train. Hopefully, we do get cut in the next pack in red. Because I feel a little bit bad. Maybe I should have forced it since I'm the one passing. But I think everybody was going to fight over red. So we'll see. So far, so okay. Furious Rise. Oh, I should have just taken that Avenger. Dang. That feels a little bit bad, but it's okay. This can be salvaged. White is not open at all. So I'm going to take Opt. I don't particularly want any of these cards. Yeah, I'm going to take Opt and maybe we end up in blue-green draw. I feel bad about not taking the Avenger. I feel really bad because the red is still flowing in this direction. So I think I could have fought for it. This is, yeah, I don't have any good cards so far. Where is the removal? Okay, I know I passed good red removal. So that's on me. The red's really flowing. I should have just taken it. But that happened, so I'm going to move on and not worry too much about it. Pestilent Haze. Ugh. Maybe I take Secure the Scene. Maybe white flows in the next direction. This is a very expensive removal spell. But it's definitely too late to move into red. I don't particularly want to be green-black. I will take the expensive removal. Okay, that's a late Watchdog. That makes me hopeful. I want the Pride Milk in here, though. Because if I end up in green-white, Pride Malkin is really solid. Now, the Watchdog is a very good 2-drop. Maybe I was supposed to take that, but I love the cat. So next pack, I really need to work on this curve. I need to prioritize 2-drops. Yeah, hopefully I get a Hallowblade. That's what I'm really looking for because that card is ridiculous. And I want some feeder resistances, you know. Titanic Growth is an okay combat trick. If you have Trample, it's great. Let's see here. I guess I'll take the land in case we end up splashing. I'm hoping I cut green well enough because some of those packs just didn't have any green cards. So I hope we get paid off in the next pack for that. I should pass all of this for signaling, honestly. I'm so used to just grabbing the uncommons because of, like, vault progress and arena. If you have all of them, it turns into, like, wild cards faster. But I should send strong signals for these, so I will. Okay. Yeah, I'm supposed to take a green card. I would never even bring this in from the sideboard. Unless, I guess if my opponent had, like, a couple really expensive liars. But that's just an awkward card because if they're a flyer stack, it could end up being, like, a Skyscanner. It's just not very effective. Okay, that was a late Titanic Growth. I'm fine. Like, so far, so okay. I can make this work. Pegasus is a 2-drop. I'm going to take it here. Well, actually, Pilferer is fine. It's kind of awkward because, okay, so you can turn lands you don't need anymore into cards. But it's just awkward because you have to pay two mana. So I don't think this card is a reason to move into green, blue, draw two. I'm going to take the Pegasus here. This card is fine. If I was in blue already, I'd be happy to pick it up. I have no blue cards besides the Opt, and I have no draw two payoff. So I'm more inclined to take white cards here. I think white will be open in this direction. Ascension is pretty good. The best use of this is to, when your opponent tries to remove a creature, use it in response, turn your creature into an angel. It feels great. But, you know, there's other cases where if your opponent has, like, a 10-10 Quaddle that has trample or something, you can turn that into an angel. That'll buy you some time. This has other applications. You can also, like, ambush your opponent, block with an angel. It's great. So I'm going to take it here, and I'm happy about it. I'm hoping to wheel Pegasus. I don't know that I'll see it on the way back, though. Ooh. Okay. So, Veteran is solid in the counters deck. Being able to just pay one white and put an extra counter on something that ends up being like an onboard combat trick a lot of times, right? It makes combat math difficult if you just all of a sudden put a counter on something. Or it just makes it tricky, right? It's great. So I'm going to take that. I think the Charger is very defensible too, but this has the highest upside. Oh, Hunter's Edge, what a gift. So I'm Containment Priest is a 2-drop, right? Which this deck wants. So I'd be happy to take that here if this Hunter's Edge wasn't here, but I'm hoping I can wheel Battalion Priest. I don't love Adept in this deck. If you have a bunch of Gale Swoopers, maybe, or a bunch of Feeder Resistances, if you have ways to get it through multiple times and make 1/1s, great, but it's not the 4-drop I'm looking for. Okay, so I need 2-drops. Here's a Charger. It's a good 2-drop. Being able to like play this and pump a flyer or something with trample when it comes in is good utility, so I'm going to take that. I don't think anything's going to come back in this pack that I want to play. Empath. I don't really particularly want 6-drops in this deck anyway. I want to keep the curve as low as possible. If I did get a colossal Dreadmaw, I would not run an Empath just for 1 6-drop. This is better in like red green, I think. That being said, I don't think I'm interested in playing any of the other cards in this pack. I think I would run this with 2 6-drops. I'm really not looking for 6-drops. I'm going to take this in case I end up wanting to splash something later on. Chorister's a gift here. I would also like a Guile. The deck needs a few more combat tricks. Guile is fine. I like Chorister a lot, though. That scales with the game. 4 power, 4 toughness, lifelink. Late game is excellent. Truffle Snout. What a sweetie. Yeah. I would have been happy to pick up Training. I'm really not interested in any more 4-drops. Honestly, I'm kind of looking to not play Maulers in this deck. So, yeah, I need to bring down this curve a little bit. But I have a whole other pack. I'm feeling okay with the lane I ended up in. I just want a couple more combat tricks, and like a Fate's Fetters would be amazing, but it's an uncommon, so I'm not expecting it. But I'll take Battalion here. Yeah, so even a bad version of green-white is still decent. It's just, I'm like 2 Acolytes away from having this deck bring me joy. 2 Acolytes and 2 Feet of Resistances, and I think this deck would be very good. It's got good bones. The Maulers are replaceable. Like, this, I'm looking to upgrade these. Secure the Scene is very expensive, so these are cards I don't want to have to play, but I would play. But that happens with any draft deck. Or not any. Drafts aren't perfect, right? Like, you're not going to end up with the perfect version of an archetype. Or, I mean, if you do, then you are very happy, because it doesn't always happen. You got to play some filler cards. Okay, so this is best of 3. I'll grab a Mutt here. There are a good bit of artifacts and enchantments, so this is a fine cyber card. It would actually probably be fine main, but like I said, I'm not really looking for expensive stuff. I don't really want a 5-drop right now. I want to keep the curve low. Battalion is fine. Yeah, I just need a couple more combat tricks. This is what I'm looking to replace. Yeah. I mean, I really want a Hallow Blade, right? That card is ridiculous. But it's an uncommon. I've seen zero Acolytes, so white must be sort of contested in this draft, which isn't surprising. It just goes so well with, like, every other color. It's I get it. It's very solid in this draft. Acolyte. It's just a busted common. It's so good. Okay. So I'm just taking those for signaling purposes. I'm in my lane now. I just have to grab 5 playables from this pack, but hopefully 8 so I can upgrade these. Pteranodon. Okay. That's a solid 2-drop. I'm happy to pick that up here. Okay, that was on the wish list. I want a couple more 2-drops. Okay, now. Combat tricks and removal would have been nice. Okay, there's nothing for me in this pack, so I'm going to take the land. I don't think you play a tap land just for a scry, especially not in a curve out deck. Some people say you should because it's scry's utility, but I want to go 1-drop, 2-drop, 3-drop, 4-drop. Removal. Turn everything sideways. Go, go, go. I do not want to take a turn off because I had a tap land. Like, this deck wants to develop the board quickly. So, I'm not doing it. Yeah. I have an aversion to tap lands. So I think that's sort of... I think it would be defensible to play it, possibly. Just, it's not for me. Primal Might's pretty good. Is it better than Siege Striker? Siege Striker is so strong. But I think with the trample stuff, this could come in handy. And I need removal. Yeah. This seems... It feels bad passing a Striker, but... this is more correct, I think. If I didn't have a lot of stuff with trample, I might be more opposed to it. The trample definitely makes it better. But it's a removal smell, a removal spell that scales up with the game. So, yeah. I said I wanted a Fate's Fetters. There it is. But passing a Visionary, it hurts. It hurts because Visionary is just it's a 2-for-1. You play some ramp and yeah, get a card when you play it. That's awesome. But this is one of the best removal spells, so I'm going to take the Fate's Fetters. And yeah, I'm not going to complain about it. That's a great removal spell. It just feels bad to pass a Visionary. Okay, now I'm gonna take the Hunter's Edge here. I would like another 2-drop. We saw a couple Chargers floating around, so I should maybe get one of those on the wheel. Hunter's Edge feels great here. This deck was missing the 2-drop Conclave Mentor. Would have been awesome with all these counters. 1, 2, 4. Oh, Visionary. Oh, I guess we don't have that many counter spells. I mean, things that put counters on things. I'm hoping for a feat of resistance still. That would be awesome. Visionary is a very nice pickup here. Okay, so at this point, Skyscanner is pretty underwhelming. I'm hoping I can replace that too, but I don't think I'll get enough playables. So at this point, my removal is good enough that I don't think I would play a Secure the Scene main. I would bring this in if I saw Taunter. Like something that my other removal isn't great with. I mean, well, Taunter, I have Ascension and Face Fetters for, I guess. Using your Ascension as a removal spell feels bad, though. So yeah, I wouldn't run this main unless there was a... I wouldn't even sideboard it unless there was a really big threat. It's just such expensive removal. All right, Pride Monk is awesome. I'm hoping... Well, is anything going to wheel in this pack? No. Like a training would be... Pteranodon. That's pretty great. Okay. I would like a training, but this is an awesome 2-drop. Happy to pick that up. My fixing is Blossoming Sands and Thorn of Falls. I don't think I would ever want to splash anything. So yeah, I'm not going to play anything here. I guess I'll just take the Empath. I'm not playing in this deck, obviously, but it's an uncommon. Yeah. Ranger's Guile, yeah. Are you kidding me? That's a late Visionary, and I'm very happy to see that. Because now I think I can get away with 16 lands. My curve basically ends at 3. I have 1 4-drop. I was definitely not I was not expecting to see that late. Definitely not. But that was a nice gift. Okay, this deck actually shaped up pretty well. Guile. Okay, let me think about this. I think I'm just going to cut Skyscanner. I don't need this. 16 creatures is fine. Okay, so I know you can organize this a different way, but honestly, I always lay it out like this. Because these are not things that I'm going to play on curve. So I just always manually separate it. This is what our curve looks like. Removal spells, combat tricks. I really wish we would have gotten 1 or 2 feet of resistances, but honestly, Titanic Earth is pretty solid in this deck with 3 Pride Malkins. Something's going to have trample. So that should come in handy to finish out a game. Yeah, this is like, it's pretty good. The curve is nice. It has good removal. And yeah, the combat tricks, I think I can work with this. I'm going to predict a 3-0 because I'm feeling like it could be that. But also like things could happen. So let's see. I'm excited. Dive in and see what we can do with this deck. All right. Stick around because, okay, like the draft is good, but you have to see if the deck works. You got to go test it. So let's do it. I never want to say 3-0 because I always feel like then the shuffler will hear me. Shh. This deck is capable of trophying. I don't like to get excited about things because having expectations like sets you up for disappointment. You know? I'm just saying. Okay. Okay, this is better. This is actually a good 6. I can throw back a land. Okay. Chorister on turn 1 is awesome. Pegasus first. If I had a Pride Malkin in hand, I would play the Pteranodon. But I don't. So I want to make sure I'm able to attack. They don't have anything for 1 black, so I just played that pre-combat. Okay. Life gain. All right. Life gain with Sanctum on turn 2. Looks like we're bringing in a puppy. Although, I mean, Sanctum by itself doesn't gain enough life to trigger the life gain matters stuff, right? You need 3 life a turn. Okay. I would love a land. I would really love a land because I want to get this Patrician off the board and be able to attack with my dinosaur. Ready? Land. Yes. Perfect. This is good for 2 reasons. I mean, I want to get the Patrician off the board, number one. It's their payoff card. I want it gone. And I want to be able to attack with my dinosaur. Now, I don't think I'm in a bad spot, but they do have 6 cards in their hand. So that's something to be concerned about. Okay. All right, so I like having, the growth is nice to try to get through extra damage in the end, but I like having the guile up in case they have removal. And this does gain me life, so it's not a loss to do that. They're on 5 lands now. They might just play like finishing blow and I'll have the guile up here. Or they just scoop. That's okay with me too. Cool. Curving out's fun. Okay, so they had the Sanctum. I don't know if bringing in Mutt for just the Sanctum is important. I think I'll leave it in the sideboard for now. If I see another target, I'll bring in the Mutt. I wouldn't be surprised if they have a Faith's Fetters or 2, right? Because they would have prioritized them very highly. I mean, most people do. If you're in white, you want Faith's Fetters, but in the life gain deck, they probably have 1. But yeah, I'm going to leave that out for now. Because I don't think the Sanctum is good enough. Okay, so this is going to be more difficult there on the play. That's a decent hand. I'm still so happy we got this visionary very late. All right, they mulligan to 6. I don't want any more lands. It's too many lands. Yep. Deal. That's a deal. Sad freebooter is sad. Good time to draw that. Yeah, so obviously visionary next turn. I don't think there's any 3 drop I would play over that. They would like to race, sure. Okay, well, you remember how I said there was no 3 drop I'd rather play over Visionary? It could just be Harbinger. I should have attacked first. It doesn't matter. They're tapped out. This is fine. They don't have a good block here. This is Hexproof from Black, so like, they probably don't have anything to deal with this year. I guess Face Fetters is a thing that they could have. Okay, so Imp was a good draw for them. That's a bummer. Now, I mean, I could test the waters. There are some people that read Hexproof from Black as protection from Black. I've had this get through before, but I don't want to take that risk. I'm assuming my opponent knows what they're doing. So I think I just play. I think I'm just going to play Visionary instead of Gale Swooper since they have the Imp and the Freebooter. I guess I could have traded this and held up Guile. Okay. Okay, the thing is, they're going to have, like, a courser activation up now. So, I want them to attack out, but they probably back the imp. Okay. I can deal with this. So, they're going to pump the chorister. Gosh, that's so good. This card's so good. It's annoying. I don't have a block for it, though. I just don't. I could block with Harbinger, but it feels really bad. Okay. Okay. So, Harbinger is going to draw me a card. Do I need to Primal Might something? This size draw card. Ugh, yikes. So I'm at six. I probably do need to Primal Might the Freebooter. I guess I could block it with Gale Swooper and use the Guile too. That's fine. Okay, so I'm just going to go with Harbinger because I do need to draw cards. I'm hoping for my own Chorister. Who even am I? I gotta be careful with what I say. I feel like I have a lot of power. Okay, so yeah, I think I gotta take a risk here and hope they don't have removal. Oh, I still have Guile up with Visionary. Okay, this is fine. Totally fine. I forgot. I left that back for a reason. Being able to trade Super for Freebooter is fine. They draw a card. It's annoying. It is what it is. Chorister is going to help me out a lot, I think. Okay, they're in the tank. I wonder why. If I were them... Okay, that's fine. That goes on imp. Yeah. Okay, so they're leaving back the chorister, which is cool. I take three, no problem. Gale Swooper blocks. Freebooter. No. Yeah. Because this is going to turn back into a 1-2. I do want to preserve my life total a little bit here. I think it's important. They are drawing a card here, which is the unfortunate part. I think at this point I'm supposed to fight the chorister. I think... Oh, dang it. Another imp is bad. That's annoying because... Oh, gosh. I can just block stuff. I wanted to be able to get in with chorister and gain a bunch of life this turn. With no consequences, you know? But now they have a dang death toucher. Ah! Best laid plans. No! Alright, so... I don't have good attacks. If I attack with Chorister, they block with Imp. And that's not great. I want the Chorister as recurring life gain. But I don't know if I can afford that. I kind of need to gain the life this turn. I think it's actually really important to send it. It's going to trade for an Imp. I need the life, though. I'm at three. They can't just let this keep coming through, though. I was going to say, there is maybe a world where they don't block with Imp here, but I would love if they didn't. But I think it's correct, because if I just keep gaining life, how are they going to get through this? Oh, they're forcing the pump? Okay, this is great because now I can just use Titanic Growth. And then after combat, play Pride Malkin. Put the counter on the Chorister. And then start pumping it with Veteran. That's good. This is a great block for me because I didn't want to trade it off here. Like, I want to be able to get more life gain in before this is all said and done. So Since I have the Guile, I'm gonna Pride Malkin the Chorister. But since they have two Fetid Imps, is that even correct? Harbinger might want it so I can draw more cards. No, I think it goes on Chorister with Primal Might. They're gonna keep back an Imp though. It might have been Harbinger because being able to draw cards would have been good. But at this point, I don't know, gaining a bunch of life feels good. I think it's okay. I think there's an argument for either or. Okay, I hope they send the Imps here. They should leave one back though, if they don't have an answer for the Chorister. Right, because at this point, this is like digging me out of the hole they were digging for me. You know? Yeah, I like this attack. So, do I trade off my... I don't want to trade off the Harbinger. I kind of want to... I'm not going to let them keep gaining life with Chorister. I can't do that. But being able to draw cards on with Harbinger is appealing, since they only have one blocker with Imp. And it looks like they're just planning on pumping the Chorister here, right? So I have more Pride Malkins in the deck. I'm wondering if it's actually correct to take a 2-for-1 here. I think it might be. I think it might be because I want this alive to be able to... I'm going to offer them a choice. Like, you can take care of my lifelinker, or you can let me draw cards. I think this puts them in a tougher spot. So I think I'm okay to take this 2-for-1. I'm losing Trample for the Chorister, but I think that's okay, considering this deck does have two more Pride Malkins. So I'm okay to take this 2-for-1. Okay, so then end step, I'm going to put a counter on the Chorister. I could draw removal for Imp too. Primal Might doesn't do it because it's fight. I guess, no. So I'm just going to attack with both. I think they're going to trade with Chorister, which is fine. I've gained enough life at this point to feel comfortable about this. I get to draw a card off of Harbinger. Since I'm drawing a card, I don't really want to use mana here to give it a counter. I think 3 life and 4 life, there's not a huge difference at this point, so I'd rather save the mana. I guess I'm going to be attacking, so Battalion's fine. Battalion with Veteran is pretty nice. Okay, so holding up Guile. All right. Yeah, this has turned around. For sure. They really like Fetid Imps. Card is fine. Okay, so they can only give one Death Touch this turn. So, okay, stay back Veteran, because I can put a counter on the Battalion. I'm assuming they're going to give Death Touch to Fetid Imp, whatever blocks the Harbinger. Because this is getting me more value, right? Yeah, I would say start there. That makes sense. Okay. Oh. I guess they assumed they had... Yeah. I think they assumed they had double black mana because they chump blocked. I didn't even notice that. Yeah, that's pretty big. I mean, it could definitely be worse for them. But yeah, I mean, not being able to trade that off with something was, it's tough. Okay, so Primal Might looks awesome here. I want to hold up Guile though too, can I? Yeah, so Primal Might on Pteranodon, and I still want to hold up Ranger's Guile just in case. I don't know what they would have in response though. So, yeah, x equals 4. Okay. Autopay holding up Guile. Okay. Pretty good. Just pretty good. That'll do. Oh! I should have did the math. I missed lethal. I didn't do the math. They weren't going to come back from that. So, yes, it was one off lethal. I had it in my hand, but I hit the next button. The equivalent of F6 I pressed. Oops. So I know what I did. I missed lethal. I didn't think it was going to be 19 in my defense. That was a heck of a lot of damage for one swing. It's okay. I'll win better next time. Promise. Yeah. This will do. Both colors, good curve. They take Primal Might, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. Okay, well, I'm glad I didn't see the Guile. That's a nice thing to have hidden. I'd prefer if they didn't see the Titanic Growth, but that's okay. Hobble Fiend. All right, I guess this lets me get in. Duress main deck. That's, I don't know how I feel about that for limited. I think that's a sideboard card, maybe. They don't want to race. Oh no. I mean, I have Titanic Growth, so they don't have a good block. I mean, I think I just let this trade. I don't think it's worth, is it worth saving a 2-1? I guess. I guess. It doesn't feel great though. But at this point, I guess I want what's on the board, right? I have two creatures. One of them is a 2-1. It's not impressive. But if I draw like a Gale Swooper, I can hop it. Like, that's fine. It feels kind of bad using a Titanic Growth there. I could have just let it trade, but I do want my creatures alive. Wow. Okay. A main phase Goblin Wizardry. All right. I wouldn't generally do that. It is awkward to put a counter on the veteran. Because it can't put counters on itself. I do have more Pride Malkins though, so it felt okay at the time because I was able to get in. I guess I should have offered the trade with that. Or I could have traded in a Guile for a token there. I don't particularly like what's going on here. What? That's very strange because they just debatably hurt themselves more than me, right? That is quite something. I'm not sure about that. So, I mean, I guess I could take the time to put a counter on this end step, but that was odd. I don't think that was correct. Whoa. Okay. Okay, this must be a newer player. Yeah, that is an oops. The thing is, they could definitely win this game because I don't have a lot cooking, you know? So yeah, I mean, playing this rare in a deck where you have a bunch of X1s, not great. Or I mean, the opponent could have maybe read the card wrong. Like, maybe they thought it said, like, opponent's creatures get -1/-1. But now they know. Face fetters. That's fine. That buys me some time. Because a 5/2 was going to be a clock. I could have traded for it, but I didn't want to have to, so this is A-okay. Aw, dang. That's some nice value for them. They still get to draw a card. They get to draw two cards, right? So they sack that. They sack this. Yeah, they get to draw two off that. That's really strong. I think they're going to sack it, right? I would be really shocked if they didn't sacrifice that. Okay, that's some good value. Yep. I don't like that. Yeah. Hunter's Edge. Sure. That'll work. I have Guile up as protection. What would they have here in response that would make this be bad? I don't think anything. But it's always nice to have a Guile around. Okay, so putting the counter on Veteran worked out. If I end up in a board stall, I can just put counters on itself until I find another Pride Malkin. It feels awkward, right? Because you have to tap to put a counter on it. But at the time, it let me attack, and I think that was good. Okay. So I get to attack into that because I have the Guile. Let me draw first just to see what I would get here. Pride Malkin, I guess, would be good. Or a forest. All right. They block because they're at 8. Makes sense. They kind of need to make me have it. Okay, I mean, at the same time, this is a free attack. So they could have blocked to say, like, I'm going to make you have it. But I'm happy either way. I got the damage, and I think that's good. So next turn, if I draw Gale Swooper, that should seal the deal. It also would be a good draw here. Gale Swooper is my best draw because it puts the Veteran into the air, and I have Guile as backup. Gale Swooper. That's a Plains. Okay. So there are 4. I could send the Missionary, but I don't think that's very good. I don't want to lose it to the Brute. I'm just going to send the Veteran and hope we draw things that aren't lands next turn. That's the plan. Well then, sure, Shrike, and I really had time to see it coming because they did it before blocks. Okay, deal. That's very nice of them. Oh wait, no, they didn't have to double block. I'm not sure why they did this for his first strike. I got to see what was coming because I couldn't do anything about that. Okay, well. I mean, I guess I save this. I don't even know if it's prudent for me to do so. It maybe holds them back from attacking with Brute here. I would love if they attacked. Okay. That's good. All right, so that's my game plan. Turn this into an angel on end step. Hope they don't have removal and then win the game. They don't have removal because they, well, they might, but they played a card and they're tapped out, so I know I'm good to go. Yes. Am I sure? Of course I'm sure. Do I want to win the game? Yes, I do. Thanks for checking, Arena. That's very nice. Getting in there for exact damage for lethal is nice. Okay. Yeah, I wonder if they sideboard out of their X1 stuff or maybe just take out that rare because it hurts them more than it hurts me, I think. Well, at the time it did. They basically just played two cards into it. That was not ideal, but they learned, right? I've definitely done stuff like that, like in the past where I've just like read a card and I thought it said something else and then you just figured out it is a rare. So like how often do you actually play that card? I've never played it in this format. I don't particularly want to, but there's probably a good deck for it. I just haven't felt the need to play it. I don't think I need to sideboard. I didn't see anything for Mutt, right? Besides the Infernal Scarring, which I'm not going to... I don't need a Mutt for that. That's fine. So, all right. Up a game. Harbinger on turn 3. They gave me the play? Oh my. I would not give an aggressive deck the play. I wouldn't do it. Okay, so Harbinger is probably safe here. Like Dragonfire to get it, but if they have a grasp, can't grasp that. Oh, it's a weird. Okay. Hello. Cool. So I'm going to attack. If they double block, I'm going to play a Titanic Growth. Ooh. If they don't block, even better, I get to draw a card. Bottoming Lands feels bad, though. Dang it. Dang it. Okay, I'm one planes away from victory. It shuffles. Oh, okay. Bottom of the rest of the bottom of your library in random order. I see. I heard a shuffling sound and I was like, did my whole tech just shuffle? No. This is so you don't know the order in the bottom of the library, I guess. Okay. So it seems like a newer player because they're just casting combat tricks. Not at instant speed, which is... odd. And they keep Death Touch instead of Lifelink. Okay. Okay. This is a lot of damage, so I could, like, lose here. If I don't draw a Plains, I'm in trouble. Okay. So, they're planning on blocking with Weird because they didn't attack with it. So I will attack, use the growth. I'm not sure about not attacking or not blocking. I feel like picking one is it's a good thing to do. I'm a little bit confused at what's happening here. Okay, so I'm gonna trade off the dinosaur with the Hobble Fiend. I think I can play the cat and put the trample in the Harbinger. I can take damage from the weird. They also might just not attack with again, which in general, you want to be like attacking, offering trades, or blocking when you hold stuff back. So it's just like, but if I don't draw planes, I don't actually know if I can win this. Okay, they're missing land drops. Okay, that's a good attack. I take four here. That's fine. Plains would be amazing. The Primal Might. This says trample, so I'm nowhere near. I think we just Primal Might on the Harbinger for full price. And hit. Okay, so this will be plus four, plus four. Have it fight the Hobble Fiend, right? They get to draw a card, which is a bummer, but okay, so do I, which is good. If I feel really nervous, I could leave back. I don't, what could they have? Is sure, I don't even think Sure Strike is lethal. Jumping there, I don't think was correct because if they had removal here and like, well, they are missing land drops. They're missing land drops. No, I guess that is correct. I changed my mind. Okay, so Pride Malkin, I should do some math here, but there are three, so Pride Malkin on the Pteranodon is probably enough. They have seven toughness. I have a Titanic Growth. Oh, this is way more than enough because I have three attackers. So I just growth the thing they don't block. I didn't need to worry too much about this. Yeah, they miss land drops. That's a bummer. Oh, and I think I even have lethal without the Titanic Growth because of trample, right? So 9, 11, they had 7 toughness. Yeah, so it was going to be too much anyways. There's no need to BM by, like, adding on the growth. I won't play an extra card. I don't like to still hot all these, you know? So I try to refrain from playing extra cards. You can. There's nothing wrong with it, but I had the win without it, so I didn't play it. Okay, off to the finals. That definitely was probably a newer player. It happens, just the way they played stuff, like, the timing of the instant spells was definitely a hint. But they could have won that game because, like, if I didn't hit my second color, I don't know. They did very well on missing land drops. Oh gosh, Boros is like the deck to beat. So gosh, Houndmaster is probably in their deck. Card's so good. Poppies. Hold down the fort, little buddy. I'm even wondering if it's correct to gain 4 life here, but It might be. Yeah. Yep. Should have gained the 4 life. They're very aggressive. Alright, well. That's not good. Okay, so I try to trade this off. Okay, they have another shock. Great, perfect. This is going to be a fast game one. Hope you didn't blink, because this game's almost over. Yeah, that's what a good curve out looks like. I didn't have it. They did. So I can trade Battalion for Ogre, in theory, if they don't have a Dragonfire. Pteranodon, in theory, blocks one of their 2/2s, but they probably have a Feeder Resistance, so there's the Dragonfire. Okay, wow. 2 shocks and a Dragonfire. Okay, yep. I don't have any creatures. So, this game is over, pretty much. Okay, I was going to say, if they don't play anything and they have nothing, I'm done. Like, Magma gets me in 2 turns. So, I'm going to try. I could theoretically draw a Hunter's Edge, right? I need for them to have lands in their hand. I need them to slow down. They send the dog. I trade it for the charger. Okay, I need Chorister. No. I am done now. That seals the deal. I was going to say, Chorister would have been turned too late. I would have needed Hunter's Edge and for them not to have Devils. Because there's no way that I can block. I can't chump block this and not take the 3 damage. And I'm done to Magma in 2 turns anyway. So, game 2. That was blazingly fast. Okay. I don't think I am supposed to sideboard. I have a decent enough curve to combat what they're doing, but they just had shock, dragon fire, and creatures. Like, it happens. Okay, all right. Okay, this is okay, I guess. These block their tutus well until I can find other stuff. Yeah. Okay, they mulliganed. That's a little bit helpful. Boris is solid. This is the finals though, so I shouldn't be surprised. They have a good deck. Okay, that's awesome. Pride Malkin right after a Pteranodon is great. I've seen Shock, so I don't think this is actually going to survive, but that's okay. I'm guessing they shock this and attack with Kura next turn. We'll see. They're not hitting their second color yet. So I think they pump here. But yeah, that's not surprising. Yep. Makes sense. I say that because, they didn't get their second color. All right. So at this point, I'm racing. Until they hit their planes, I'm not super worried. Okay, so here. Okay, they didn't want to trade it. What does that mean? Could they have a dragon fire? I think here I'm supposed to Primal Might this for 2 and hold up Guile. Because they could have, okay, this is a 4-4. They could have a shock here. Okay, they missed their second color. These are like the fastest games ever. Oh! Okay. Getting their only creature off the board there was going to be really solid, though. Game 3, but they're on the play. I don't have any good sideboarding options. I mean, I guess I could bring in the vine, but that feels bad. I don't think I'm that desperate to have something to block. I have Chorister. I have enough 2 drops. These are pretty solid against them. This is like the fastest match ever, though. I'm really... I don't know what to say. It happens. These are both fast decks, and we both stumbled each game, I guess. Faith's Fetters helps. Is it Primal Might or Hunter's Edge? This scales up with the game, but Hunter's Edge is better with Pride Malkin. So I'm gonna keep the edge. I don't actually know if that's right. This hand is a little scary because I would like to have a 2 drop in my hand. That's nice. That's a really nice card to draw. I like it. Okay, it's probably gonna get dragon fired. That's my prediction here. Them not attacking, they could have attacked that. I wouldn't have blocked. I would have been too scared. at this point, I might just play the Truffle Snout and gain 4 life. Because, okay, it can trade with the Battalion. They did show 2 shocks, though. So maybe it's better just to play it as a 3-3. I'm not ready to attack here. At this point, I'm just blocking both. If I hadn't seen 2 shocks, I maybe would have been tempted to... Oh, gosh, there it is. I would have been tempted to gain the 4 life against them. Okay, it's only draw 1. That's not too bad. When you get to draw 2 cards off that, it's awesome. I mean, I'm trading. Maybe not. I can Hunter's Edge the Battalion next turn. I think I want trades. I think I trade here, and I think I'd play the Pride Malkin, and then if they attack with stuff, just block. Let me think about this. So, Trouble Snout's a good blocker right now. It's a really good block right now. Okay, maybe I do Hunter's Edge the Houndmaster. That attacks, plus X, plus O. Yeah, since I have 2 Hunter's Edge, I think I'm going to do this. Do I want to attack? I'm not blocking. But they don't know that. I think I can attack here. Fate's Fetters helps me in this race, right? And I have removal in my hand. Watchdog. Magma. Okay, they have a large board. So I could Hunter's Edge and then get in for 5 again. This is awkward. I mean, I could just block. I might just be blocking now. What are they gonna do about 5/5? I guess they could have a that expensive removal spell. Turn to Slag? I can never remember the name of it because it's not that exciting. Gale Swooper. Okay, so they're gonna hop a Watchdog. That's good. There's nothing I can do about that. Okay, so I have to Hunter's Edge the Gale Swooper, I think. I'm avoiding putting a counter on Pride Malkin because I've seen 2 shocks from them. So I'm just sort of like growing the pig. The things they could have to deal with this now, it's gonna be a 6/6, so like red really doesn't have a whole lot to deal with that. The Geyser? I don't think I can attack because if they shock the Pride Malkin, I'm taking a lot of damage. I do have Face Fetters though. They could have Face Fetters for the Truffle Snout. Yeah, there's the shock, which makes sense. Siege Striker. Okay, that's pretty good. I can Face Fetters that, though. That's a lot of damage, so I think I have to do that now. Yeah, because if they tap their whole board, that's too much damage. Just kind of fetters that. We take 1 from the magma, go to 13. I have to do this because if they tap their whole board, that's a lot of damage. I don't want to, and I can't really chump either. So now am I supposed to attack for 6? Because, well, I take way more back. So no, I don't think so, even with the fetters. I do need to close this game out, though, at some point. So, like, it's rough because I use a lot of my removal already. If they have a feat of resistance, that's not going to feel good. dub. Oh, that's, yeah, it's good. It's pumped. Okay, well, that's a problem. They pump it twice. Can that get past a 7-7? Yes. And I already used the Faith Fetters, Hunter's Edges, and the Primal Mites on the bottom of my library. Yeah, I can't, I don't think I can beat a dubbed Kerr. that's pretty good. That's pretty good. Okay, so I'm putting the counter here because I want to protect from Dragonfire. I can't protect the Pride Malkin from Shock. Dub on a Kerr is very good. Like, that's trouble for sure. They're not attacking with it. That's kind of wild. It is a good blocker, that's for sure. Yeah, so my best draw is Gale Swooper, so I can give the Harbinger wings. Okay. And draw a card, that would have been nice. I'm not sure why they're not attacking with Kerr. I guess they're fine to be patient with this magma, but like I could have more removal, right? In theory? And I'd have to be chumping that every turn. Because they can pump it. I mean, that's huge. That's a lot of damage. I think they're supposed to be making me chump, but I'm not sure. It might have changed now because I have a big board, but and they are slowly pecking me to death with this Magmut. I can't attack into that. Remember when I said, what does red white have to deal with a 6/6? A Kerr that can be pumped with a dub. Yeah. That'll do it. Oh. I was like, why are they pumping that? Okay, that makes sense, yeah. I don't trust the auto-tapper, so I'm not going to let it auto-tap. It might up-tap my planes. Visionary. That's a planes. So, yeah, I'm trying to think of what I can even draw here. This magma is slowly doing it. Okay, so now Turret Ogre, my Gale Swooper isn't even good. I guess I could swoop the Trouble Snout. There it is. That's yeah. I can't block. Destructive Tampering will do it. Okay, so if that was in their deck, they were just waiting to draw it. That makes sense. And they had Inevitability with the Mutt, so like the board stall made sense. Okay. Yeah, and that's fine. I think that card is a good finisher for Boros. Alas. I'll take my 2/1. Yeah. I think this deck was capable of trophying, but sometimes the cards just don't line up. Bummer. All right. Anyway, yeah, I'm happy with 2/1 for this deck. Like I said, I really wanted Hallowblade. That would have been amazing. It's a great 2-drop, but this deck had it. I mean, it had the potential. Good curve, good removal, decent creatures. Yeah. I'll take the 2/1. I would have liked a trophy though. It's all right. Okay, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you taking the time to watch these videos. Thank you. And please hit that like button, subscribe, comment, all appreciated. Come hang out with me live. I stream on Twitch at twitch.tv/JamieTopples. Would love to see you. I hope you have a wonderful day. Thank you again for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Take care.